Hello everyone! Today we're going to learn on how to form a sentence using demonstratives. But first, what is a demonstrative? Demonstrative is the part of a speech that you use to indicate or specify a noun that you're referring to. In English, common demonstratives are this and that. They are gender neutral. Can be used for both, either a masculine or a feminine. Unlike in Arabic, demonstratives can be either a gender neutral or a gender specific. Now, how do you know which one is which? To answer this question, anything that is plural like those or these, it's going to be a gender neutral. But if it was singular, such as this or that, then it is a gender specific. For today's video, we are going to learn the demonstratives for singular and plural. So let's start. Demonstratives for singular are هذا, هذا. It means this for masculine. If the subject is masculine, then we use هذا. هذا. هذه. هذه. It means this for feminine. هذا. هذه. That for masculine is ذلك. ذلك. And for feminine, تلك. تلك ذلك تلك هذا هذه ذلك and تلك. Match the correct answer. Pause the video and do it by yourself without cheating. Here we go. هذه means this for feminine. ذلك means that for masculine. هذا means this for masculine. And lastly, تلك, that for feminine. Great job. Another exercise just to make sure it's all clear. True and false. هذا is used for feminine. That's right, it's false. هذا is used for masculine. Next question. تلك. تلك means this. That's correct, it's false. تلك means that. هذه is used for feminine. That's right. It is used for feminine. And lastly, ذلك is used for masculine and it means that. Great job. It's true. Yes, ذلك means that and for masculine. Well done. Moving on to plurals, which are gender neutral, means we don't care if the subject is masculine or feminine. We have these, هؤلاء, هؤلاء, and those, أولئك, أولئك, هؤلاء, أولئك, هؤلاء, these, and those, أولئك. Complete the missing letters. Pause the video and give it a try. It means this. هؤلاء. هؤلاء. Next one means this. Pause the video and complete the missing letters. Great job. It means أولئك. أولئك. Bravo! We can combine noun demonstratives with both a definite and an indefinite noun. For those of you whose English is not their first language, definite is anything that has the boy, the girl, the, which define the subject, and indefinite is a boy, a girl. Now that's not a problem, but definite, the something, and indefinite, to something. For example, this is the man. The man is a definite noun, which means الرجل. الرجل. It is a singular and masculine noun. So use هذا. Demonstratives, just like in English, they always come before the noun, leading to this sentence. هذا الرجل, which means this is the man. We'll do more exercises. Don't panic. This is the book. This is either going to be هذا or هذه, followed by the, which means ال. And book is كتاب. Kitab is masculine, which we're gonna use هذا الكتاب. Next, this is the girl. This is either going to be هذا or هذه. The ال girl بنت. This is the girl. هذه البنت. Why هذه? Because البنت is a feminine. That is the boy. That is either going to be ذلك or تلك. The boy, the ال, and boy is ولد. ولد is the masculine noun. ذلك الولد. ذلك الولد. I hope you're getting the flow. Our next sentence is that is the school. That is either going to be ذلك or تلك. The ال and school is مدرسة. مدرسة is a feminine noun. So we're gonna use تلك. تلك المدرسة. تلك المدرسة. These are the boys. These are هؤلاء. Straightforward. هؤلاء. The ال and boys أولاد. هؤلاء الأولاد. Last sentence. Those are the women. Those are أولئك, the, ال, and women, نساء. أولئك النساء. If I'm using a demonstrative to a definite article, this means the phrase has changed depend on whether the object is definite or an indefinite. If a demonstrative is followed by a definite noun, you get a definite phrase. However, when you attach an indefinite noun to a demonstrative, the result is like this or are. Let's do some examples. This is a student. Let's say the student is masculine. This is going to be هذا or هذه. I said the student is going to be a masculine, so we're going to use هذا, and a student طالب. هذا طالب. This is a table. Table is طاولة, means we're gonna use هذه طاولة. Those are girls. أولئك بنات. Those are boys. هؤلاء أولاد. That is a university. That is تلك university جامعة. تلك جامعة. تلك جامعة. That is a man. That ذلك man رجل. ذلك رجل. And lastly, what if I want to combine a demonstrative clause with a definite subject, noun, and an indefinite adjective together? What we will end up with? We will end up with a descriptive sentence. Let's do some example. This girl is beautiful. This is either هذا or هذه, but girl is بنت and بنت is feminine, so we're gonna say هذه is beautiful. Beautiful is جميلة. This girl is beautiful. هذه البنت جميلة. هذه البنت جميلة. These girls are tall. If you have realized, we have a demonstrative clause, a definite subject, and an indefinite adjective, which means we will end up with those, أولئك, girls, البنات, YL, because it's a definite subject, and tall, طويل, but since it's plural and feminine, it's going to be طويلات, طويلات. أولئك البنات طويلات. أولئك البنات طويلات. That school is big. That ذلك أو تلك. School مدرسة. But it's gonna be a definite subject. We're gonna say المدرسة. And big كبير. It's a feminine. School is feminine, so it's gonna be كبيرة. تلك المدرسة كبيرة. تلك المدرسة كبيرة. This man is tall. This, هذا or هذه. And man, because it's followed by an indefinite adjective, it's the subject is gonna be definite subject. So we say الرجل. This man is tall. هذا الرجل. And tall is طويل. هذا الرجل طويل. هذا الرجل طويل. That book is difficult. I want you to pause the video and give it a try. I'll make it simple. That is ذلك أو تلك. Book is كتاب. And difficult is صعب. Or صعبة. Depend on what the gender is. Pause the video and give this a try. 3, 2, 1. I hope you said ذلك الكتاب صعب. ذلك الكتاب صعب. That was all for today's video. I hope you find it a useful video. Please make sure you like, subscribe, so we could meet again for my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to watch my lessons in this playlist. They are structured and organized, each lesson, one video by another. In case you don't miss out any video, I'll keep the link in my description box. Along with We All Need Revisions, I do put revision quizzes in my community YouTube section, but if you think that's not enough, then I recommend you to give my Instagram a follow and comment on my post so I could check out your answers individually. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye.